are live in outer space riding on a giant asteroid at Sunny Alpha Stadium, home of the Galaxy Chaos.
Oh, that would explain the text I just got from Event Horizon Wireless, informing me I got $5,000 in roaming charges. I wonder how much that text just cost me.
Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The new Yuck Tyrants go up against the Galaxy Chaos. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If the sound of a torn Achilles followed by laughter and taunting brings a smile to your face, you are tuned to the right place. Hi everyone, Grim Blitzrow and the MFL crew is coming to you live on game day. Bricks, any thoughts on today's game?
I thought I had one, but I think I might have forgotten it. I remember. I forgot who's playing today.
Careful what you asked for, Grim.
And it's first and 10. Four yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6. Lateral to his teammate. We're talking.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much.
Third down and 5. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
And the punter takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have to meet at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
First and 10. Oh, and he just turns a fumble. You've got to protect the ball better than that. Second down and a lot. Receiver's pocket, and the defense gets a turnover. And like Brix's bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
And it's first and 10. them to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. On that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Third and 2.
Well, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
Pass and catch for 3. Receiver needs to break some tackles. Second down and 7. It's a 6-yard gain. Third and 2. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my offseason.
It's first and 10.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. The receiver makes a grab for 5 yards. Second down and 5. And the defense spiked the offensive water with strawberry fields. And now they can taste sound but can't remember what the concept of time is. And he picks up maybe 4 on that play. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game.
Oh, could it be mine?
And that'll bring a 3rd down in inches. And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play! A little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can and keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. That's how you run it, folks. Picks up 8 there. Second down and 2. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's first and 10. Target more often. And it's first and 10. Call that about a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
And it's first and 10.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Good thing they know. Good and into the end zone with a burst of speed.
I think he's more of a downer's guy than a speed fake grip. He's running from his demons, it's clear.
And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10. He's supercharged and can electrocute any opposing player he touches. There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit. Just called a time warp dirty trick, and now it's like everything that just happened didn't.
Get Fritz's mom on the phone quick. I want to use 13,000 of those time warps, and I'm doing mistakes she did about
this. And this guy, defense called a warp speed dirty trick, and he fumbles it, Fritz. That was a screwed up play if I ever saw one. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. First and 10. Can he
about six on the play.
And that'll be second down and four. And this guy runs angry and runs hard. First down. Footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole, up here. Talking to you.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit.
Third down and 10.
2 minutes remain in the half.
Wait, I got to take a dump.
Third down and 10.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here. Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first timeout.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
First down and 6.
And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and 10.
Kaboom! And the quarterback on the ball, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out.
That pass was way off target, but I'm pretty sure the QB will blame the receiver as he always does.
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. Well, that was a good throw.
Yeah, if he was aiming for the ground.
The kicker should make this, but you know how it goes in this league.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty...
I don't remember that being an officially sanctioned MFL rule.
Down and, well, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref.
which coincidentally happens to be Brent's match stoopsing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
He picks up 9 yards on that catch. It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
The teams come out of halftime all tied up and ready to battle it out.
Oh, geez, Grim. I hope someone ties them soon. They gotta play football.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
Game picking up some steam, a gain of 7 there. Second and 3. Man, he's running like a bull on steroids. That'll be a first down. And it's first and 10. Pick up for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4. Up 4 on that pass and catch. Second down and 6. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First and 10.
It looks like the defense handed out shrinking pills.
4 yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6. And that pass finds its target. A pickup of 6 yards on the play. Third down and a pussy here. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey. Should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up?
first and 10. And that's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
And it's first and 10. I hope you covered your ears, Bricks, because that was a sonic blast dirty trick. And they're picking up chunks of yards now. Nice reception for 10 yards. Second down in inches. They've used a strawberry field's dirty trick. Those guys don't know which way forward is now.
Oh, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Graham.
And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. They're going to be able to return this one. Hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. And it's first and 10. And that is caught for a first down. We're tied up at the end of the third quarter. You can smell the excitement on the fans. I mean, literally, it is ripe in here. Man.
Junior, was that you?
Hey, blow me.
And he held on to that one for a first down. And it's first and 10. Heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Get the ball, asshole.
Second down and 10. That's a 4-yard gain. Third down and 6. For a second there. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. Well, surprise me. He made it look easy and he gets 3 points for it. They need to call an attack ref dirty trick and stop this or they're going to lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, Grim. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. Chance for a good return here.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and 10. They've called a zap attack. The ball carrier better move his ass out of bounds before he gets fried. Oh, welcome to Fumbletown, USA. Population, this guy. Well, he should be more careful when he hurdles. He could go all the way. He's at the 10. Touchdown! The defense erases the previous play by transporting the offense back in time.
I heard that Time Warp Dirty Trick uses advanced alien black hole technology.
Yeah, your entire life is one big black hole.
Second down and 9. And this guy looks like Thor on a revenge bender right now. And there's another pick. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Into a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and 6. Not much there, maybe a yard. Third down and 5. Drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10. And that's the way to get the sticks moving. He picks up 5 yards on that play. Second down and 5. Nicely done for a first down.
Ah, oh, that is such bullshit. I got money on this game. These guys need to talk to the ref about those calls. And by talk, I mean stomp them into the ground.
Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. They just went zebra hunting, and it looks like they got their trophy. Second down in a mile. And the runner is moving crazy fast. Look at the pass. Oh, he just got crushed. Third down and the punter is warming up. First and 10. 2 minutes left in the game, and we'll be right back after I top off my drink.
What am I doing?
And it's first and 10. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down. And they stop the clock with their first timeout to try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. Second down and 10. Fingers, he should have had that one. Third down and 10. This guy's a brick shithead. That pass was good for 10 yards. The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just cock-blocked the clock.
In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
Yeah, big deal. Missed a meat for brains, ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
Some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! First and 10. Defense calls rush speed. Man, that defender just turned on his...
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Oh, this guy just loves punishing the defenders. That's a first down. First and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
We're deadlocked with a tie score at the end of the fourth, and that can mean only one thing. Stay tuned, because what the hell could be more important right now?
Well, now that you mention it, Grim, I really need to hit the can.
Breaks overtime is a war with some basic rules. The first touchdown wins the game, but if the team that receives the kickoff gets a field goal, then the other team is allowed a possession too. After that, whomever scores wins.
Grandma, I didn't understand any of that. Can you repeat it?
Not a chance. And it's first and 10. Could not connect on that play. Third down and 9. Does the QB know which team he's on? Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
It sounds like my offseason.
First and 10. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I gotta, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Up maybe 4 on that play. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. Nice punt. Should move them back nicely. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog being snagged.
Oh, mama. He just knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, be okay.
And it's first and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6. Down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
KO. today. That was one hell of a slugfest. That was worth the price of admission, right, guys?
Well, I paid for admission. I expect girls dancing on a pole or something.
Girls win. I want a lap dance.
You don't even have a lap, you little freakazoid.
Call me.
Let's see what the MVP has to say about today's outcome. Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Microhard Corporation. They get it right every up.